Hey, everybody, it's Alan, and I hope that you're doing well. Okay, so it's Tom Waits time. It's been a little while since we've done a Tom Waits song. It's definitely been a little while since we've done a Tom Waits 2-for-1. And so we're going to do one right now. We're going to do the song Get Behind the Mule. First, we're going to do the original Tom Waits version, and then we're going to follow that up with the John Hammond version, which is probably a little bit more well-known.
Jimmy the Harper with a hard little pistol and a lariat. She going to the bottom and she going down the drain. Said she wasn't big enough to carry it. She got to get behind the mule, yeah. In the morning and plow, yeah. Got to get behind the mule. In the morning and plow. You got to get behind. The axe in the woods, you got to meet me by the fall down tree. A shovel of dirt upon a coffin lid, and I know they come a looking for me, boys. I know they come a looking for me. Got to get behind a mule, yeah. In the morning and plow, and get behind a mule. In the morning and plow, get behind a mule. Get behind a mule in the morning and plow. Well, Big Jack girl was 8'1" and he stood in the road and he cried. He couldn't make her love him, he couldn't make her stay. Tell the good Lord that he tried. Got to get behind a mule, yeah, in the morning and plow. Get behind a mule. Morning and plow, yeah. You got to get behind a mule in the morning and plow. You got to get behind a mule in the morning and plow. Dust the trail from Atchison to Placerville on the wreck of the Weaverville stage. Beautified, painted for a lemonade. I was stirring my brandy with a nail, boys. Stirring my brandy with a nail. Got to get behind a mule in the morning and plow. Get behind a mule in the morning and plow. You got to get behind a mule in the morning and plow. Get behind a mule. Widow James, Jack the Cutter, and the pockmarked kid. They had to stand naked at the bottom of the cross and tell the good Lord what they did. And tell the good Lord what they did. You got to get behind a mule, yeah, in the morning and plow. Get behind a mule, yeah, in the morning and plow. You got to get behind a mule. Get behind a mule, the morning and plow. Punctuated birds on the power line, in the Studebaker with Birdie Joe Oaks. I'm digging all the way to China with a silver spoon, while the hangman fumbles with the noose. Boy, the hangman fumbles with the noose. You got to get behind a mule in the morning and plow. behind the mule. The morning brown. Pin your ear to the wisdom post. Pin your eye to the line. Never let the weeds get higher than the garden. Always keep a sapphire in your mind. Always keep a diamond in your mind. You got to get behind the mule.
I have to admit, a thought crossed my mind. I wasn't going to stop between songs, but a thought crossed my mind when I was listening to this particular track again. So Alison Krauss and Robert Plant had tremendous success with T-Bone Burnett doing the Raising Sand album, and it kind of had this unique, really sort of mystical, almost Creole swampy kind of bluesy bluegrass feel. I mean, it was completely different than anything had come out at the time. And there's a part of me that's listening to this and thinking to myself, do you think T-Bone Burnett had any kind of influence or inspiration come to him from listening to Tom Waits? You know, Tom's always had a really interesting way of orchestrating his group with different instruments that wouldn't normally show up in a, you know, contemporary song. Unique sonic characteristics, unique vibes to his songs. And it just, again, it's just the top of my head, but I'm thinking to myself, did T-Bone Burnett, when he was actually working on something to the effect of Raising Sand, you know, did he gain any inspiration from Tom Waits? I don't know if there's an answer to that. It's just something that popped into my head as I was listening to it this time. All right, so here's the John Hammond version, which I first heard in the soundtrack for the movie The Last Castle, starring Robert Redford and Mark Ruffalo. Tony Soprano. I can't think of his name right now to save my life, but I will think of it during the song, I am sure. So without further ado, here is the John Hammond version of Get Behind the Mule.
Molly be damned, smote Jimmy the harp with a horrid little pistol and a lariat. She's gone to the bottom and she's going down the drain. Said she wasn't big enough to carry it. She said, get behind the mule in the morning and plow. She gotta get behind the mule in the morning and plow.
She gotta get behind the mule in the morning and plow. She gotta get behind the mule in the morning and plow. Choppity chop goes the axe in the woods. You gotta meet me by the fall down tree. Shovel of dirt upon a carbon lid, and you know they'll come looking for me, boys. I know they'll come looking for me. You gotta get behind a mule in the morning and plow. Gotta get behind a mule in the morning and plow. You gotta get behind a mule in the morning and plow. You gotta get behind a mule in the morning and plow. Big Jack girl was 8 foot one. He stood in the road and he cried. He couldn't make her love and couldn't make her stay. But tell the good Lord he tried. Tell the good Lord he tried. Gotta get behind the mule in the morning and plow. You gotta get behind the mule in the morning and plow. You gotta get behind the mule in the morning and plow. You gotta get behind a mule in the morning and plow. Dusty trail from Atchison to Placerville, on the wreck of the Weaverville stage. Beautified and beat it for a lemonade. I was stirring my brandy with a nail, boys. I stirred my brandy with a nail. You gotta get behind a mule in the morning and plow. You gotta get behind a mule in the morning and plow. You gotta get behind a mule in the morning and plow. You gotta get behind a mule in the morning and plow. We're the rampaging sons of the Widow James. Jack the Cutter, the pop mop bit, had to stand naked at the bottom of the cross and tell the good Lord what they did. Tell the good Lord what they did. You gotta get behind the mule in the morning and plow. You gotta get behind the mule in the morning and plow. Get behind the mule in the morning and plow. You gotta get behind a mule in the morning and plow. Punctuated birds on the power line in the Studebaker Buddy Joe hoax. I'm digging all the way to China with a silver spoon while the hangman fumbles with a noose, boy. With a hangman fumbles with a noose. You gotta get behind a mule in the morning and plow. You gotta get behind the mule in the morning and plow. You gotta get behind the mule in the morning and plow. You gotta get behind the mule in the morning and plow. Pin your ear to the wisdom post. Pin your eye to the line. Never let the weed get higher than the garden. Always keep a sapphire in your mind. You gotta get behind the mule in the morning and plow. Gotta get behind the mule in the morning and plow. You gotta get behind the mule in the morning and plow. You gotta get behind the mule in the morning and plow.
Could not think of the name James Gandolfini before I started that version to save my life. It popped into my head about 30 seconds into the song, and I wanted to stop the song and actually say it, but I chose not to do that. Yeah, it's a really good version of the song, and that's the thing. Tom Waits doesn't have your traditionally beautiful voice. It's scruffy, it's rough, it's raw, it sounds like sandpaper to some people. But he's a tremendous poet and composer. And again, it's a really unique vocal styling that I happen to absolutely love. You know, I've said it in previous videos and I'll say it again. I think he is one of America's, if not America's, greatest musical poet. I put him in the same categories as Bob Dylan or James Taylor Carol King, you know, any of the great American songwriter poets, Jim Croce. And yet I like Tom Waits better than all of those people. He's a really unique writer. He comes up with unique rhythms, new unique instrumentation for a particular song. His voice is completely his own. And then the way he has his songs that end up getting covered by artists, whether you're talking about, you know, Rod Stewart or in this case, John Hammond, or I think who else has done? I think Bonnie Raitt's covered a song of his. I mean, he's had a lot of commercial success without him actually being the one performing the song. He wrote it. And I actually feel like there was something very recently that an artist covered one of his songs and ended up winning an award, and I'm completely and totally spacing on it right now. And maybe it was 2023 or 2022 I'm thinking of. I'm not 100% sure on that. But I absolutely adore Tom Waits as both a singer and a creator. And yet it's always interesting for me, and part of the reason I do this playlist is so that I can compare the original version by Tom with one of the artists or a few of the artists who have actually covered his songs. I mean, he's had his songs covered by so many people. There are a lot of duplicates out there. And I've done another video. I think I did one video that might have had four different artists performing Tom Waits songs. And again, it's one of those situations where you're just... I've said this about another particular group, but you have the admiration of your peers. You have such amazing creations that other artists want to put their own little spin on something and create something fully unique. And it's one of the biggest, in my opinion anyway, it's one of the biggest compliments you can get as a musician or an artist, is to have somebody else pipe up and be like, I love that song. I want to perform that song. And I just always think it's really cool. So if you haven't seen The Last Castle, watch it. It's a pretty good movie. I like it a lot. It's one of my favorite Robert Redford movies. And yet it has this sort of unique undertone of justice versus injustice. And yeah, it's a unique storyline. You don't see storylines like that. You know, it's a truly original storyline, in my opinion, in a lot of ways anyway. Well, that said, hope you enjoyed this. Hope you enjoyed this Tom Waits 2-for-1 featuring Tom Waits and John Hammond doing this song, Get Behind the Mule. All right. Please feel free to leave a comment in the comment section below. We can talk about it further. Just know that I appreciate you all and I wish you well. Take care.